Hello, my name is Hira Singh Manja. I am thanks to D.Y. Patil College of Engineering to organize International FDP on Environment and Sustainability. Today my topic is Green Chemistry and Sustainability. In last 2 weeks, I have uploaded 2 videos and that video link we have here displayed. Now in the 3rd week, again I have displayed the 3rd video. In this video, the video outcomes are: after learning through the video, student will understand core concept and method from ecological and physical sciences and their application in environmental problem solving. Ensure about green chemistry put back into the nature cycle. Understand the transitional character of environment problem and way of addressing them, including interaction across local to global scale. This video is observe or indicate the ISO 14001:2015 and ISO 9001:2015. First ISO is related environmental management system, and second ISO is measurement analysis and improvement of the QAMS through activities like internal audit and corrective and preventive action. A certification and mark of excellence that enable organization to demonstrate their success in cutting their carbon footprint. There are 4 carbon footprint: reducing, CO2 major, lower carbon and carbon neutral. In the environment, there are a number of ways to escape the carbon dioxide, scope 2, scope 1 and scope 3. Here we have seen in the diagram. In that we have mentioned the cars, industries, buses, etc. Green chemistry analytical methods are minimize potential for accident, prevent waste, maximize atom economy, less hazardous chemical synthesis, safer chemical and products, safer solvent and reaction conditions, increase energy efficiency, use renewable feedstock, avoid chemical derivatives, use catalyst, design chemical and product to degrade after use, analyze in real time to prevent the pollution. Green chemistry not just a definite solution but an ultimate necessity. So green chemistry created in United States in early 1990s. In 1991, the Environmental Protection Agency defined green chemistry, that is the design of chemical product and process that reduce or eliminate the use or generation of hazardous substances. So here in this diagram we have shown the green chemistry, that is renewable energy, renewable feedstock, reduction in GHG emission, prevention of resources, then efficiency transformation process, reduction in the consumption, chemical products. So this is the eco-design of chemical product. Life cycle analysis is a method used to quantify the potential effect on the environment of service or a product from the extraction of the raw material required to produce is to its end of life channel. So here is the end of life, and again here start recycling, then chemical industry, non-chemical industry, transportation, distribution, uses, and again end of cycle. The impact of chemistry is left in all industries. This is the energy saving. There are 4 main parts: reduce consumptions, recover lost energy flows, optimize feedstock source, optimize procurement, identify source of profit. So in the reduced consumptions, facilities, investment in the best available technologies, sites, sober plants, exergy analyze, auxiliaries, optimization of utilities, operation, metrology, sequencing, behavioral. Now second, recover lost energy flow, facilities, heat recovery, that is retrofit, site, process, integration, waste, incineration, methanization, etc., and industrial ecology, integration covering entire industrial park. Optimize feedback source, thermal auto production, that is cogeneration, biomass, solar thermal, geothermal, etc. Electrical auto production, that is PV, wind power, cogeneration, etc. And last is optimize procurement, identify source of profit, that is procurement is reduction in number of contract, energy storage and flexibility, synchronization of consumption with energy price, load shedding, network service contract, etc. Here we have seen the carbon fluxes in gigatons. So this is the base diagram to identify the atmospheric carbon fluxes, that is 775. Here is vegetation and soils 1960, surface sediment 150, and recoverable fossil fuel 4000. Here is the case study of atmospheric carbon dioxide, that is we have seen previous slide, that is atmosphere escape 730 carbon dioxide. So the graph to the left show the killing curve which plot the increase in atmospheric carbon dioxide between 1958 and 2005. The average net annual rate implies by this curve is about 11 gigatons of carbon dioxide per year. The figure to the right shows a simplified view of the source and sink of carbon on Earth. Note that for every 44 gigaton of the carbon dioxide molecule, there are 12 gigaton of the element of carbon which is shown in the graph. So problem first, from the value of the source and sink, the assuming they are constant in time, create a simple differential equation that give the rate of change of atmospheric carbon in gigatons. So its solution is dc function of t divided by dt is equal to plus 119 plus 88 plus 6.3 plus 1.7 minus 120 minus 90 minus 1.9. So dc of function t is divided by dt is equal to final answer is plus 3.1. Now in the second problem, if the current carbon dioxide abundance is 384 ppm, what does your model predict for the carbon dioxide abundance in 2050? So its answer is, since we are interested in the carbon dioxide increase, we use equation CO2 function of T is equal to 11.4 T minus 20,300. So for T is equal to 2050, we get CO2 in 2050 is equal to plus 3070 gigaton of carbon dioxide. Since 384 ppm correspond to 330 gigatons of CO2 by simple proportion. So 3275 gigaton correspond to 384 ppm into 3070 divided by 730, that is equal to 1600 ppm of CO2. Carbon dioxide change. A simple mathematical model, that model the carbon dioxide change is given by P of x is equal to 1.8x plus 352. So here x is the number of years since 1990. So problem first, what does this model predict as carbon dioxide abundance in the year 2012? So answer is 588 ppm. Now second problem, in what year might the carbon dioxide abundance be 50% higher than it is in 2012? So the final answer is 2143. So Eastwards global impact calculator. Global environment impact calculator can be used to tally the actual environment benefit of using Eastwards recycle. The tool will be calculate your environmental impact by determine the amount of number one toxin diverted, second critical metal saved, and third is greenhouse gas avoided. So here in this diagram we show the carbon dioxide emission by production sector. It is in all over world. So that is electricity and heat, other energy, industry own use, industry and construction, transport, other sector not residential and residential. All of these are given in the graphs. Thank you very much.